Today, I'm going to talk about the Multipass sling bag from Janji. .26 miles, 9 minutes, 37 seconds per mile, 140 beats per minute. For my Saturday long run, getting treated to an absolutely beautiful sunrise today out along the lakefront. Winds weren't too bad and temperatures were relatively mild, so having just an absolutely great time running with the Janji Multipass sling bag. Now, before I get my thoughts into this running pack, I want to go over some disclosures. This is a bag that was sent to me by Janji for the purpose of review. However, they're not paying me to make this video or to use the bag. No one's paying me to make the video or use the bag. And no one's getting a chance to see any of this footage or preview it until you guys get a chance to see it this video on YouTube. Now, with the disclosures out of the way, let's talk about this bag. Now, this bag can be worn a variety of ways. It can be worn as a sling, like I was for all that running footage, but it could be worn with the bag up front, or it could be worn as like a traditional fanny pack. The idea with this bag being it can be used as a running pack, but it can also be used, and I think it's primarily intended to be used as like a very small day bag, not like a hiking day bag, but if you're traveling and you're out exploring a new area, a new city, a new region, you can easily pack your phone and a couple of other things into it. So let's go into some of the pockets in the bag. There's an outer pocket that is nice and roomy for if you have like a packable rain layer or something very small that can fit in here, it'll fit. There's a little pocket here for a key card, or if you want to put a credit card also in there, you could do that. There's a little loop in here if you want to attach your keys with like a carabiner. Otherwise, your keys can fit in here really nicely. There's another zippered pocket that's a little bit further back and a little bit more kind of secret, not secret, but stowed away, where you could easily fit like a phone and any other documents or papers that you wouldn't want to be in like an outer pack. Again, if you're traveling, you're worried about pickpockets, that kind of thing. It's a little bit further in, a little bit harder to reach. Now, the main pocket that I'm particularly interested with this guy is in between this outer pocket and the inner pocket where I was storing my phone. There's an area, it's expandable, where I was able to put this large water bottle. And so that was how I was carrying water with me on my run. I ended up being out there for a little over 2.5 hours today. So definitely wanted to have at least a little bit something, even though the temperatures are pretty mild and I wasn't really sweating hardly at all. Something you're out there running that long, definitely want to have some water along with you. So that's how I ran for today. Now, the way that I was running with it is, for the most part, I would have it with the running pack in sling mode so that the water was behind me. And then there's an extra strap here that you can use it to come kind of underneath the armpit and cross up front and give it a little bit more stability so it's not swinging around as much. And this is actually the second time that I ran with this pack like this. I also ran with it last week as well, just to kind of give it a shot. Last week when I ran with it, I had some kind of fit issues, so I felt like I couldn't really get it quite snug. Now, there's ways to kind of cinch up both of these straps, and I had a hard time with it last week, and so I felt like the bag was bouncing around a little bit too much. I wanted to give it another try. Definitely found the way that it fits me a little bit better this time, and I had no problems with the bag bouncing around at all. Now, I normally run with a variety of packs. I run commute right now with the Osprey Daylight Plus, which is a 25 liter bag, and that one bounces around quite a bit. And I do get a number of comments from people when I show the footage of me running in that bag, saying like, doesn't it bounce around too much, or all that bouncing and swaying would drive me crazy. I think slow motion exacerbates how much a bag is swaying compared to how much you actually feel when you're running in it. So, but that is my favorite run commuting bag, but it's a lot larger than this. Other running packs that I've used is the Nathan Vapor Car 4, version 1. I think they're on a version 2 now. That one's a little bit different. It's more of a traditional running pack. It's got spots up front where I can have two water bottles, additional spots to store food and nutrition, side pockets along the side strap, and then pockets in the back for either a bladder or to store other gear. I've run with a drone back in there, or you could put rain layers or other kind of clothes in there if you needed to. I'm finding that that Vapor Car 4 is a lot more packed than I typically tend to need at 4 liters. I used to love the idea of having all the water up front, because that way when you're running, you just take a sip real quick and you're good to go. But I'm kind of not liking the front loading of the water. It's starting to become a little uncomfortable for me. The main thing with that one is I bought it at a time where I think I was a little bit bigger than I am now. And so I'm having a hard time cinching it down and really getting it tight. It's always flopping around. And that one, whenever I wear the Vapor Car 4, I get a lot of comments saying like, man, that thing needs to be tightened, or it's too big, or I agree with you guys, it's a little bit too much. And I typically find that most of the pockets in that thing when I run with it are empty, and so I just don't need it. So I've been looking for something else. I'm also looking, especially for the winter, for a way to not have the water on the front, because as you're running, the cold air hits you, the water will tend to, like, if not freeze, it's not going to freeze solid, but it'll turn into like almost like a slushy consistency, and basically you're then running with ice packs on your chest, and that's not all that comfortable from a temperature perspective. Very refreshing to drink, but not super comfortable. And so I've been looking for a way, I think, to put the water in back. When I saw this on the Janji website, I asked if they would send me one of these, and I've been pretty happy with it. Now, the other thing that you can do is you can, again, adjust all the straps that attach to you. But this, if you don't want to use it in kind of running mode, you can always tuck this inside. There's a way for it to get tucked away inside very neatly. So that way, if you're running, or if you're using it like this and wearing everything up front, or using it as a fanny pack, this strap isn't just kind of dangling around. But running today with this, with a water bottle full, I filled it all the way to the brim because I had brought some of the Unived Elite drink mix with me. I was running with a wild watermelon flavor for today. Very tasty. When this was absolutely full, I definitely felt like it was a bit heavy in back. And with the way that the sling is, the water was, you know, it's being held at an angle. So I felt like there was a little bit more weight on this side than this side, so I felt a little bit unbalanced. Nothing that like threw off my stride or anything like that, but something that felt, I just felt it. I knew that it was there, and I was thinking, well, maybe it's not fitting right. So I was kind of adjusting with it, trying to get it to sit a little bit more evenly, but it just kind of, I think just the way it is, it's gonna sit a little to one side more than the other. About halfway through the run, I started taking some drinks from it. I was able to unclip like the extra strap, this one, swing it around so it was like this, and run and get the bottle out and drink from it, no problem. And then get the bottle back in. Actually, I think I threw it back in kind of like this way. And I did this while I was running. It's not the most comfortable thing to do while running fast. I can't imagine doing this while running fast. But for today, low heart rate training, just going out for a leisurely Saturday long run. If it was a situation where I'm exploring a new place, doing a little run tourism, I think that I could either stop at a stoplight, that kind of thing, or stop, take a break somewhere, get the water out, and then put it back in, and it'd be fine. So I think for the intended use, it's fine. If I were doing like a fartlek or doing any sort of speed play and trying to get this in, it would only be something I mean doing like on a rest period, or I'd have to take a break. I don't think I'd want to do this while I was trying to run really, really fast. So that's kind of the caveat to this bag. But for the way that I want to use this bag, the kind of thing that I'm looking for, to have something along with me that's not quite as intense as a vapor car, but able to at least handle a little bit of water and maybe a snack or two in the bag, another layer in case I come across some weather. I think this would be a really nice addition for me to have, make it a little bit easier for me in terms of not having everything like in my pockets or having a speed flask. I know a lot of you guys love speed flasks to have that like strap with the water bottle attached to your arm, but I'm already carrying a camera. So for me, my personal preferences, that's not kind of my favorite thing to work with. So this is how I'm using the Janji Multipass Sling. It's like such a tongue twister. This is how I've been using the Janji Multipass Sling bag. I've been enjoying it. It's relatively cheap compared to other kind of running packs. So something that I think that I'm going to get a lot of use out of. I really like it. And for those of you who are not familiar with the Janji brand already, Janji does donate a portion of everything it sells to clean water projects around the world. If you want to learn more about Janji and what it's doing, I did have the opportunity to interview one of the co-founders of Janji a little while ago. We went for a run along the lakefront. I'll post a link to that video down in the description down below in case you want to check that out. So that's all I have to say about the Janji Multipass Sling Bag. I still can't say that really quick without, I can never get it on the first try. That's all I have to say about the Janji Multipass Sling Bag. Let me know in the comments if you have any other questions. I'd love to talk to you guys more about it down there. Before I go, I want to talk about a new charity runner for this week. This week, it's Nelson Kanarathingal. Nelson, let me know. I apologize if I'm mispronouncing your name. Let me know if I pronounce it wrong. I'll try to get it right. But Nelson is raising money this month for Movember. He's growing a beautiful mustache, and he's doing it to spotlight and put awareness on men's mental health and suicide prevention. A very worthy cause. I was happy to donate $70 to Nelson's fundraising efforts, and I'll post a link in the description in case you'd like to learn more. That's all I have for today, everybody. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end of the video, and I'll see you tomorrow. Yo, what's going on?